Hello everyone, you are all welcome to lecture number 1238, and today's topic is the nomenclature of heterocyclic compounds, or we can say naming, how to give the name to each heterocyclic compounds. And for nomenclature, actually either Arabic or Greek terms are used for heterocyclic compounds. Most of them are named on the basis of either Arabic term or by Greek term. And the nomenclature starts from hetero atom. For example, if suppose there is one compound like this, so in that case, the hetero atom is here, part of the ring. So numbering will start from hetero atom. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, like that. For example, if it is like this, it is the part of benzene ring, this nitrogen, and then numbering will start from here, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6. If it is 5 member, for example, like this, so numbering will start from here, 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. So this is the way to give the name of the heterocyclic compounds. So here, number one, some rules that are observed while naming of the derivatives of simple heterocyclic compounds are given below. A. Arabic numerals and less commonly Greek letters denote the position of substituents in heterocyclic compounds. The simple heterocyclic compounds are generally numbered in such a way that hetero atom gets the lowest number. Hetero atom gets the lowest number, and the numbering proceeds counterclockwise around the ring, especially in the case of monocyclic hetero compounds. So here it is counterclockwise is the numbering. For example, if you take this pyridine, here hetero atom is nitrogen, so numbering will start from hetero atom nitrogen. So one is the hetero atom, lowest number will start, and that is counterclockwise like this. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6. In case if there is one methyl group substituent at this position of the pyridine ring, then the numbering we have to start in the same way, from the lowest number nitrogen, 1, 2, 3 and 4, 5 and 6. So the name of this compound, because at 3 position, so you have to put 3 here, there is methyl group. So the name of this compound will be 3-methyl benzene. Oh, sorry, 3-methyl pyridine. Now, the other group of heterocyclic compound is where more than one ring is fused with hetero atom nitrogen. For such type of numbering, again you have to go like that. So 1, 2, 3, 4, then 5, 6, 7, 8. And the name of this fused two ring heterocyclic is quinoline. So here I have given the heterocyclics where more than one rings are fused and where more than one or two heteroatoms are there. And in the C classified heterocyclic compounds where they have given the name on the basis of paraffin, because there are aliphatic hydrocarbon rings and they contain different type of heteroatoms. So here B, sometimes we have condensed heterocyclic containing two or more rings, and the fused rings may be partly carbocyclic, means all made up of only carbon, or and partly heterocyclic. For example, like indole, benzofurane, carbazole, quinoline, isoquinoline, or completely heterocyclic, for example, purine. So all the structures are given here. In this case, it is indole, where two rings are fused, one is 6 member, another one is 5 member. Here it is benzofurane with oxygen is the part of 5 member ring, and the it is fused with 6 member aromatic ring. And the third one is quinoline, where both are aromatic ring, and one nitrogen is the heteroatom of one of the benzene ring. And once this nitrogen is shifted either to ortho or para position, then it becomes quinoline. Then the other one is where both are 6 member, and in this 6 member, one is the part of ring oxygen and other is ketonic group. So this type of heterocyclic is called benzopyrrole. And this is purine, where both the rings are being substituted with 4 nitrogen atoms. 2 nitrogen atoms are the part of 6 member ring, and other 2 nitrogen atoms are the part of 5 member ring, and this is called purine. Number C. Sorry. More recently, heterocyclic compounds have been given class names which symbolize their chemical behavior, whether it is aromatic or aliphatic chemical behavior, like heteroparaffin. Heteroparaffin means it is aliphatic ring, and the names are pyrrolidine, tetrahydrofurane, and piperidine. So here the structures are given. First one is, this one is your pyrrolidine. The second one, where the oxygen is the part of 5 member aliphatic ring, paraffin ring, is called tetrahydrofurane. Here aliphatic 6 member ring, where heteroatom is nitrogen, is called piperidine. And the last one, where the 6 member paraffin aliphatic ring, where heteroatom is oxygen, is called tetrahydropyrene. So in this way, the introduction, classification, nomenclature of heterocyclic compounds in a very simple way is over. Now I will be starting the individual heterocyclic compounds, their preparation and chemical reactions and their physiological importance. With this, I will stop. Thank you very much for watching the lecture.